爱个 SJR。
最近上到美国各大社会新闻版面的是一起非裔美国牧师在帮邻居浇花结果被警察逮捕的新闻哦。那警察的密录器画面公开之后，整个逮捕的过程就一清二楚，待会儿我们就来看看，而且来彼此交换意见。顺带一提的是，如果你想要看一些特别的国外新闻、影片、影集，或者是使用国外有地区限制的网站服务的话，使用 VPN 就是最简单的方法。 SurfShark VPN 在全世界有数千个伺服器，上网的时候不再是直接连上网路，而是间接连上 SurfShark 的伺服器，再连上浩瀚的网际网路。这么做的好处，除了上述可以使用有地区限制的国外网站服务，从国外网站购买可能有价差的服务或产品，最重要的是使用 VPN 的话，网路就无法追溯你的 IP 位置，只能追踪到 Surfshark 的伺服器，这就大大保障了你的资讯安全，减少骇客窃取各自的机会，阻挡企业网站获取你的网页浏览记录。如果你是一个很注重隐私的人，非常建议使用 VPN。 现在使用 Surfshark 还是一个账号不限装置同步使用，使用我的专属折扣码 JRLeeRadio 就可以享有17折优惠，订购两年方案再获得免费3个月的使用，保护你的资讯安全。 Surfshark VPN。今年5月，在美国阿拉巴马州 Childersburg 这座城市里，56岁的 Michael Jennings 在邻居家院子帮忙浇花。那这时候有邻居报警说，社区里有可疑人士在活动。当警察来到现场的时候 ，Michael Jennings 是拒绝向警方出示自己的身份证件。那有一个名词哦，叫做 racial profiling， 它的中文是种族归纳，意思就是执法人员依据人的种族或者是肤色来预设立场。这样的事情我们在台湾真的是比较少遇到，但是我们试想，如果我们今天生活在欧美国家，然后其他人因为我们的黑头发、黄皮肤就先入为主的对我们有预设立场，这个就是 racial profiling。譬如小时候我在美国长大，我跟爸妈去玩具店买礼物给堂兄弟姐妹，过程当中呢，店员就紧紧的尾随我妈妈，其实就是怕我们家偷窃哦。那我爸当然就很不爽，跟店家吵了起来，大概就是这种感觉。Michael Jennings 在现场就指控警方是在 racial profiling， 而警方则认定他是极度不愿意配合、妨碍公务。以下是警方当时的密录器画面，我们一起来看看。
Howdy.
Hey man, how's it
going? Pretty good.What you doing here, man?
Water flower.
Are they saying that? Is that your vehicle?
No.
It's not?
It's the neighbor's vehicle.
The neighbor's?
314, I'll be on 13.
Okay.
Yeah, 10-4.
You live here?
No, I don't live here.
Okay. They're saying that this vehicle is not supposed to be here and you're not supposed to be
who's
here.
Who's saying that?
They called about it. I don't know who called.
I'm supposed to be here. I'm Pastor Jennings. I live across the street.
You're Pastor Jennings?
Yes, I'm looking out for their house while they're gone.
到这边双方其实都保持得很友善哦，但是接下来警察要求 Jennings 要出示 ID 身份证件，待会儿我们会检视阿拉巴马州相关的一些法律条文哦，但是我们先看接下来发生的事。
Well, that's cool, huh? Do you have, like, ID and
all? Oh, no, man. I'm not gonna give you no ID.
Why not?
I ain't did nothing wrong. Did
well, nothing look, listen, I'm not saying you do nothing wrong.
Doc, listen,
there's a suspicious person.
Look, I used to be a police officer in Goodwater. Don't come here with that.
Okay. Look, man, don't do this to me. There's a suspicious person in the yard, and if you're not one to identify yourself...
I don't have to identify myself. It's not a stop and identify state. That guy know me. He came to my store that got broke in. I live right over there across the street. Who called y'all?
That's what we got to figure out. But
yeah,
first,
who
I...
Who called?
Do you live
black
here?
Man
he don't live here.
His neighbor problem. You think
I'm not saying nothing
illegal.
About...
You have no right to approach me if I ain't did nothing suspicious or nothing wrong. Told him I'm a pastor. I pastor until I don't want to hear
Sir.
You want to lock me up? Lock me up.
Nobody wants to
lock
me up.
Lock me. I'm not showing y'all anything. I'm going to continue to wear these flowers.
Call.
I don't care who called y'all. Lock me up and see what happens. I want you to.
Hey, man, just come here and talk to us.
I'm going to wear these back flowers.
很不幸的是，后来直接演变成直接上铐带上车。
We're just trying to talk to you, man. Come here.
13, 3, 4, 10, 4.
We got one that's not listening to. Look, man. Let me see your phone. Let me see your phone, dude. Just calm down. Okay?
No.
Stop.
I like this.
Okay. We're just trying to talk to you and
Sir,
see.
I don't
want to
argue with you. Okay.
All right. Go ahead. Don't do what you got to do, Doc. Do what you got to do. Go on and lock me up.
Look, just have a seat.
You're not locked up. You're just.
It's already lost him, Doc.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Just
have a seat,
okay?
Okay. Already lost
him. Sit down. Sit down, man. Just.
Okay. Let me call my wife.
You're not calling nobody.
My son just got racially profiled in Michigan. He's got his master's degree. He's an athletic director. three police profiling, came in. I was ex-police officer from Goodwood. I told you I'm a pastor.
Okay, look, man.
Who called y'all?
I don't have to ID myself. You will not listen.
I have a call on you. You have to identify yourself to me. You understand what I'm telling you?
No, I don't.
Hey, you know what? 10:15. I ain't gonna sit there and have that, dude. No, you ain't let nothing now.
接下来，警方找到了报案的 A 小姐哦。结果 A 小姐出现的时候，她表示自己搞错了。其实她是认识 Jennings 的，而且她也知道 Jennings 跟这一户是好朋友。如果她当初知道是 Jennings 的话，就不会报案了。
Do you know that gentleman? Back?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Does he have
permission? He lives right there.
Okay. Does he have permission here to be watering flowers?
He may because they are friends.
Okay.
And they went out of town today, so right. He may be watering their flowers.
Okay.
Be completely normal.
Okay, that's fine. If he would have said, hey, I got this, gave his identification, because he's a suspicious person.
Yeah, he lives right there, and he would be watering their flowers. This is probably my fault.
Okay.
Right, I didn't know it was him.
Yeah, I got to keep their flowers watered while they're gone. You okay?
Listen to me, man. Anytime the police come out and they say, we want to identify you, you have to identify yourself, because there's a reasonable suspicion, there's a reasonable man, there's a vehicle. There's a reasonable suspicion that you're here. It's not a crime.
Yeah,
if you would have said, yeah, here's my name, here's everything,
no,
we were like,
I
okay.
I told him my name.
You didn't tell me your name.
I decided, he asked me who I was. I said,
you didn't give it to me when I first
pastor
asked.
Pastor Jennings.
That's not a name. That's a pastor.
Yeah.
I need your name.
The way y'all handled this situation was totally wrong.
Well, listen.
You're racial profile.
We're not racial profile. No, sir. We're not about that.
I told you I was here watering the flowers.
How do I know that's the truth? Anybody?
I had water holding in my hand. I was watering the flowers.
Anybody can pick a hose pipe up.
He is going to be so pissed when I tell him I got arrested watering his flowers.
What is your social?
I'm not going to give him a social.
You need to give me your social.
I'll give you my name. That's all I'm going to give you. You're not going to run no 27 and 28 on me and get me in the system for no reason.
All right, what's your name?
The girl already told you who I am.
Okay, yes,
Michael Jennings. That's all you
Michael Jennings.
Michael Jennings.
Spell your first name.
M-I-C-H-A-E-L.
A-E-L?
That's it.
Jennings, J-E-N-N?
Yes, sir.
I-N-G-S. G-S. What's your date of birth?
1-17-66.
All right. Sit in the car for me.
Yes, sir.
What are we going to do with him?
You'll see the charge of, I guess, disorderly conduct, the failure to obey a police officer. He refused to give any information.
He said he's not going to give me his social, but he gave me his name and date of birth.
Okay, and she's saying the same thing. She won't give her name.
后来 Jennings 的女儿和太太也出现了，太太还带着她的皮夹来，但是 Jennings 在警车内呢，透过车窗跟她太太说
okay.
No, that's fine.
Okay.
No, that's fine.
Okay.
If he don't give me an ID and we don't have a way to identify him, I will have to book him on John Doe. But if he's got it, then that's fine. Okay. At this point, he's already collected the charge. Once we place him on arrest, we can't un-arrest him. Does that make sense?
This is so simple. And the neighbor just told him this morning, please water the plants and take care of it.
He said that, but it was all afterwards. And all we told him was, like, if you're here to water the plants, that's okay. Just please identify yourself, just your name, and let us call the owner. And he didn't want to do that until he caught the charge. So...
这起事件在美国社会新闻版面上引起了很大的关注哦。事后，他的邻居 Roy 也证实，他是真的有请 Jennings 来过来帮忙浇花。
So yeah, we were upset about it. It was upsetting to know that we asked him to come out here and he got arrested for that.
后续 Childersburg 警局撤销了对他的告诉，而阿拉巴马州的相关法律是这样的哦，在公共空间，执法人员得以盘查任何他合理怀疑正在犯罪、已经犯罪或是即将犯罪的人士，得以要求对方提供姓名、住址以及要求嫌疑人说明自己的行动。Michael Jennings 遭到盘查的地点是在邻居的院子，不属于公共空间。即便警方合理怀疑他有即将犯罪的意图哦，但是他依法提供了自己的姓名、住家位置，也说明了自己在替邻居浇花。但是提供身份证件则不是他的法律义务。所以很显然的 ，Jennings 是非常清楚相关的法律条文的，也决定要捍卫自己的权益，不向警方让步。那么现在也在向警方提告当中哦。我们再加一点背景知识进来哦。Michael Jennings 是出生在1966年，美国1967年将跨种族婚姻合法化哦，但是一直到2000年，这已经是非常近代的事情了哦。直到2000年，阿拉巴马州才正式废除了禁止跨种族婚姻的法律。所以，如果我们站在 Jennings 的立场来看呢，他生长在一个仍然是充满了许多种族偏见甚至是歧视的时空环境。 即便是现在的美国社会啊，对于种族议题呢还是非常的分歧哦。光是最近释放的迪士尼小美人鱼真人版电影的预告片哦，就引起了很大的争论了。我们要不要来拍一部呢？但是在看完了警方的密录器画面之后呢，我有两个问题想要请教大家，请大家来分享大家的意见哦。第一个，你们觉得在这起事件当中，警方有涉及到所谓的种族归纳 （racial profiling） 吗？警方有因为 Michael Jennings 是黑人而在盘查他的时候已经带有预设立场吗？你的感觉是什么呢？第二个问题是，如果今天你是 Michael Jennings， 你会决定要依法捍卫自己的权益到底呢？还是会想要小事化无，出示自己的身份证件了事呢？我很想要知道大家是怎么想的，赶快把你的意见分享在下面。如果喜欢今天的影片的话，也可以记得帮我们按赞、分享、留言。想要给予我们一些支持的话呢，也可以加入我们的频道会员，我们会非常的感谢的。好的，期待看你们的留言，那我们就下一部影片再见，拜拜。